Namaste, this is Rizwan Syed with NRI News 24x7. Today, we have with us Mr. Vishal Prakash Shah, who is the co-founder of Synersoft, a company that provides data security solutions. So, welcome to this conversation with us, Vishalji. Now, my first question to you is about the Indian budget. The Indian budget 2023. It's been referred to as the Amrit Kal budget. And there have been a lot of talks about this budget, the way India is going to go ahead. And even the foreign investors are now looking at India with more focus on investments coming into India. All this said, there is one very important segment of business in India, and that those are the startups, the SMEs, and the MSMEs. How do you think this budget is going to impact this segment of the business?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Syed. Thank you very much for having me here. Yeah, this is very interesting. And what is the effect or impact of the budget on MSME is anyway very, very important, important point, because MSMEs are contributing to 30% of our GDP. They are employing almost 11 crore people of the Indian population. So I have to comment on this particular budget, I would say that it is a reflection of, a spirit, to promote MSMEs and to promote industrialization. I remember long back, our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Modi, once in his interview, informed that, he would be more interested in small companies, he would be more interested in 500 small companies employing 50 people each instead of one company employing 25,000 people, So that is what MSME, and not only this government, even the previous government also never lost its focus from MSMEs. So basically this budget is very much like connecting the dots. So let's say, for example, in last 1 year, we have seen many announcements, we have seen an announcement of, Foxconn making, investment in India for manufacturing the processors, electronics processors. India was never self-dependent on processors, which we hope that it will. Similarly, India's defense sector was also opened up, in last budget or last to last budget, and private parties and partnership with private parties was also very much deliberated and encouraged also. So basically, now when we talk about MSMEs, who are these MSMEs? These MSMEs are small companies who are either exporters or they are the suppliers to large enterprises. And these are the large enterprises like Foxconn or, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, or there are many other companies which are there in defense sector, working under DRDO. So these are the large companies, either foreign companies, Indian large companies, which are making the investment. And I would say what Tata, Maruti, or Bajaj had done in Pune and Manesar, in good old days, basically, is going to be repeated. I'll tell you, in Pune itself, there are 4,000 MSMEs who are depending on Tata, Mahindra, and Bajaj, as their vendors, and they're part of their excellent vendor development program, which has covered technology upgradation to everything else. And now they have emerged as even the exporters also. So they have gone through that learning curve. So this budget specifically resonates the same business model, where MS, where large investment is made by a large company, that large company wants so many vendors to run its show, and these vendors are MSMEs, and these vendors go through that vendor development program, and then they upgrade themselves, they continue to update themselves, they supply to those companies, they also export. So basically, this is a very, very proven kind of business model. And this is what actually what I meant by connecting the dots. Now coming to the budget part. So when these MSMEs become the vendors to these large companies, this fresh investment coming in, as well as the existing MSMEs, most of the MSMEs who are supposed to cater to defense or who are supposed to cater to electronics, there is a scope of value added derivative products, you know, like let's say right. you have chip manufacturing in India, and from those chips, you know, you can of course make mobile phones, you can of course make computers, you can use it as auto components, you can also use these electronic parts to make the sensors and the systems which can boost mm-hmm. industry 4.0 or which can boost smart manufacturing, which is going to be right. dependent on IoT and basically on AI, artificial intelligence, automation. Mm-hmm. And their MSMEs have a great, great scope because they can actually develop such value-added derivative products from mm-hmm. This kind of large productions coming in India. So that is one part. Now, looking at this particular budget, the first thing mm-hmm. I have noticed is last year MSME ministry was allocated around 15,000 crore of rupees. And this time they have got 21,000 crore of rupees. Okay. Now, MSME ministry is majorly looking at the upgradation of MSMEs in all terms. Like MSMEs are getting subsidies on getting ISOs done. They are also getting a lot of subsidies by putting up the plants or factories in certain economic zones. Apart from that, they are given a lot of infrastructure to train or skills development for their own employees. So this 21,000 crore budget, you know, given to MSME ministry is going to really, I would say, uplift the state of MSMEs in terms of their technology adoption, in terms of their skills development. So it is a very, very positive and progressive thing, you know. And mm-hmm. This investment is going to be in the skills development, and skills developments are very, very permanent things. You know, they generate long-term results or returns. Another point I have seen that as these MSMEs become vendors to these large companies, of course, they will require technology, they will require skills, they will require workforce to run the show. At the same time, they will also require capital. And in this particular budget, 9,000 crore extension is given to credit guarantee scheme for MSMEs, basically, where government becomes guarantor for availing the capital for MSMEs, either for CapEx or for working capital. So this is also going to solve so many liquidity problems for MSMEs, and they will have enough money, you know, to do the business and to grow their business. So these are the two things which I see that, you know, very, very favorable for MSME sector, and MSME sectors can really make the best out of it.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Vishal. Now, you know, as you have rightly said in your conversation, that MSMEs and the big players are looking at collaborations. MSMEs are the vendors to these bigger players. Now, when collaboration happens, there is information that is transmitted between the two ends. And when information comes into play, there is also a very important requirement, and that is security or securing that information. Now, data is going to play around between the MSMEs and the bigger players, and of course, their sub-vendors and this entire business groups. So what are the challenges that are pertaining to data security and the data security norms which the bigger players would generally have for these MSMEs, and how would Synersoft contribute to solving this business problem for the SMEs?
Very interesting thing. You know, we need to understand this challenge, and this is high time we all understand these challenges, because otherwise, if these challenges are not dealt with, in an urgency, MSMEs will lose a lot of opportunities. You know, as you rightly suggested, that these large companies, it could be a foreign company having FDI in India, or it could be a Indian company. First thing, you know, which is the cause of, these challenges for MSMEs is the difference in digitalization. So when we talk about a large company, you talk about Tata, Reliance, Bajaj, or any American, British or German company, even Chinese company, operating in India, there is a big difference. I'll tell you, those people have already digitized, they have invested a lot in digitalization of everything, every process, everything they have in their business. And MSMEs are yet adopting that digitization. Okay, so most of the MSMEs, for MSMEs, tally is MSME and MSME, IT is tally and tally is IT, something like that. Okay. I mean, they are not beyond that, most of the times. So right. there is a big lead, these large enterprises have, with the MSMEs. And these large companies have already digitized, and now they are exploring smart manufacturing, Industry 4.0, IoT, automation, robotics, and all these things in enhancing their operational efficiencies, in making themselves more and more competitive. Now, when they visualize that they will have a vendor network, mm-hmm. that vendor network has to be, good enough to cope with all their digital initiatives. This is the big right. challenge for MSMEs, number one. These MSMEs, this challenge is not very easy to solve. It will take a lot of efforts to solve, because MSMEs have an adverse reason for that. I'll tell you what. Now, these companies want their vendors to comply with their information security standards, to comply with their data protection provisions. At the same time, these MSMEs are struggling to digitize themselves beyond accounting or maybe CRM. What is happening for these MSMEs? These MSMEs are very small companies, and when they want to cope with their principals or their customers' IT setup, they need IT talent on their side. Right. Right. Now, when they want IT talent on their side, they can neither recruit, retain, or afford an IT talent. We know IT industry is in a different orbit. A very right. junior IT talent is very expensive. I would say a 3-year IT engineer would cost more than a 20-year salesperson in an MSME, so this is the differential, and it is really difficult for MSMEs to have IT talent on their side, and unless IT talent is on their side, they cannot really right. comply with what their principals and customers are expecting from. Even government is now expecting every vendor to comply with information security and data protection, because it deals with a lot of classified information. And we have recently seen that the solar industry and Solar Industries Limited and its subsidiary Economic Explosive Limited in Nagpur, got completely hacked, and Pinota rockets, BrahMos, and some other information was leaked from them. And they were the vendor, actually, to DRDO, basically. And they were the vendors, MSME vendors to the DRDO. So this was an example. If it is not taken seriously, right. There can be irreversible loss to that. So this is a big challenge for MSMEs to cope with the information security standards their vendors would, take. So first problem they face is availability of IT talent. And second problem is, in order to comply with information security, or in order to provide for data protection, whatever IT industry, whatever solutions IT industry has to offer, you know, they are developed with a different design thinking approach. So most of these solutions are designed for a large scale usage, you know. Any product, you know, any product when it is developed or any solution when it is developed, you know, viability and economic considerations are always there when any company which is developing a solution or product. So most of the IT companies found that, you know, if a product is developed for a large scale usage, it becomes more viable to sell because large companies adopt IT more swiftly than a small company. So most of these products are designed, you know, for a large scale usage, and that is a design thinking approach. Now, what has happened as a result of this design thinking, most of these solutions and product which are useful in data protection and information security are loaded with a lot of features, you know, and that is the reason they are expensive and complex. And many a times, most of these features are not useful for a small scale usage. Okay,
absolutely.
So I'll give you an example. I'll give you an example. Let's say every firewall is loaded with two features. One is load balancing and another is multiple bandwidth management. Now, an MSME does not have multiple bandwidth. He will have a good broadband connection. That's it. And he never has anybody inbound, you know, in his network, you know, just like a bank would have his customers, you know, logging into its servers and inbound traffic. So load balancing has to happen on the traffic. No, nothing like that. So MSME sometimes is required to adopt these such complex technologies, make payment for those features which he or she is not going to use it. At the same time, these type of technologies are going to require IT talent to implement, IT talent to maintain. So this is a challenge, and actually this is a fix. So that is where I would like to, you know, draw your attention that this is something which is really a fix. Now, coming to your question, how Synersoft helps them. So when we started, we actually visualized this particular challenge in 2008 that MSMEs will be, MSMEs will be required to adopt technology, not as a choice. They would be mandated, or it would be compelling on them because their customers would require. And at that time, whatever options they have in standardizing their information technology, in protecting their data from loss, leakage and theft, or in protecting the information to avoid any competitive exploitation or any default on the compliance by their customers, they will have a choice of products which they would find complex, feature loaded and expensive. And even if they are ready to invest in such complex and expensive systems, they will not have IT talent on their side, and which will fail them basically. So we visualize this, and we visualize that, you know, there can be, this is a big gap, you know, it is a very good product market gap basically. Where products are designed for a certain market, which is a large company's market, and it is trying to be sold, you know, in, to a small scale company. And there is a gap between product and what market requires. So we came up with a design thinking, and our design thesis was that 20% of the features satisfy 80% of the customers for its 100% of the requirements. So I might have selected 20% of the features which are required by 80% of the MSMEs, and it will satisfy 100% of the requirements. So it was necessary to minimalize, you know, it was necessary to minimalize these products basically. Otherwise, if an MSME had to, you know, standardize its IT infrastructure or invest in standard IT infrastructure, they had to invest in 8 different systems: file server, mail distribution system, endpoint controller, domain controller, backup system, storage system, antivirus, so many things, you know. Now, for a 20, 50, 30 users company, deploying 8 systems is not, you know, really appealing, you know, and it is not affordable also. So we thought that let us reduce on the features. So when we reduce on the features and focus on exact features which they require, we will require lesser resources to run those features. So when there are hundreds of features, it requires multiple hardware. But when there are specific features, it will not require multiple hardware. So when we cut down on the hardware, we can save huge cost, you know. And that is how we visualize that let us have a single hardware, single software product, you know, where it will run all the features, all necessary features would be run on a single hardware. So it will be less resource intensive. And because it is having lesser features, because it is single hardware and single software, MSME does not have to manage multiple software, you know, it will be easy for them and it will not require very highly talented IT professionals to run that, you know. So we have solved this problem at two levels. One, we designed a product, which is now known as Black Box, which is a single hardware, single software. So it gives MSME what they require. It does not give anything what they don't require. So minimalization of the features. And second is what we have done is we have made it very simple. It can be run by a 12th pass employee of an MSME. So that's started Black Box certification programs, you know, Black Box certification program. And see, in India, after 12th, there are many kids who don't know what to do, you know. And we offer them this kind of certification so that they can get employed to our Black Box customers, or they can be employed to such an MSME who is supposed to comply with the requirements of its customers, basically. So this is how Synersoft helps MSMEs. One, we have given them a product which is single hardware, single software, very affordable at the one third of the cost, you know, compared to those feature loaded multiple systems to be integrated and maintained. And it requires a very low cost kind of resource to manage and maintain it. Because it is very simple.
Right. So, Vishalji, like in your conversation, you said that you have a Black Box certification program. So how do you skill up these people who have passed out from their 12 standards or, you know, just done their graduation and they want to acquire the skill? So do you have training platforms online and offline, and how do you go about that? And second is that once they are certified, what is the placement that comes to them? Like how many people get placed?
Yeah, so I'll tell you, basically, we have a full-fledged academy, you know, where we provide a Black Box certification program. And till date, we have not charged anything for that. We don't charge any fees for that. Whoever wants to learn, you know, how to support MSME on information security and data protection, they are welcome and they enroll with us. They get trained for that. Now we have done it at three levels. First, we have created so many entertaining and story driven short movies, you know, so they are kind of stories, you know, like an employee, there is in data protection, there is something called insider threat mitigation, you know, MSMEs are more vulnerable to insider threats, you know, people go and take their data.
Yeah, the IT perimeter are getting breached.
Right. So we have created approximately 50 such short movies acted by professional actors with a storyline. And we have tried to, you know, explain this particular concept to the layman. And these 12 standard students or graduates who are not really experienced with the organization environment, they don't know all these things in reality. So by watching those movies, they can actually understand what could be the challenges, what could be the tactics, you know, by the people who want to breach the data. So that is one. Second, what we have done is we have in our product design, we have made sure that our product is not more than 5 screens in our product. You know, complexity of the product is determined by the screens. So our product is never beyond 5 screens. So for anybody to learn 5 screens in 22 hours session is extremely easy. And third is what we have done is we have created certain levels. So BCSP 1, BCSP 2, BCSP 3, and black belt BCSP. So the first level, they watch these movies, they understand the requirement, they try, they start operating on the software. At the another level, we put them in a real situation. You know, let's say there is an installation, they are part of it. Third, we mandate that, you know, they have to independently do everything. And it is not only creating jobs, it is also creating so many entrepreneurs. I'll tell you, let's say there is a remote place in Nashik, for example, where, you know, someone wants to become an entrepreneur. Okay, so we tell them that, okay, we have acquired new customer in Nashik or whatever remote place. And you go and install, and we will pay you, let's say, a certain amount per user. So they go, they install per user that particular software, and then they submit the installation report, and that they, then they get paid, you know, which is far more than what salary they would. So it is also encouraging the entrepreneurship in very remote areas also.
Right.
So at three levels. One, you know, a theoretical knowledge, two, practical knowledge, and third, which is we call black belt, when they complete five installations, they become black belts, basically.
Okay.
So, yes. And how about placement? I'll tell you. See, we have 10,700 plus deployments of black box, you know, in India.
Okay.
So, one or the other customer looks for someone, you know, who can manage the product very well. And we have a database of BCSP, so we either offer them employment or we put forward their applications as on employment basis, or we tell them that why don't you pay them on per instance basis and they can become good entrepreneurs. Okay. And I'll tell you, for example, we are paying, let's say, 300 rupees per user configuration. And let's say there are 50 users organization. There is a 50 user organization. This guy can go for 2-3 days and earn 15,000 rupees. Okay.
Absolutely.
If he goes in the job market, he might earn 15-20,000 in entire 1 month, you know. So, so we are also encouraging such entrepreneurship to them.
That's really awesome. But thank you, Mr. Vishalji. Thank you for being with us here today and sharing your outlook on budget 2023 and also doing a very educative conversation around what Synersoft is doing to get the MSME secured, and also about the upskilling opportunities for 12 pass and graduate students who can connect with you and then start becoming an entrepreneur. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sayed. Thank you very much for having me here. And it was a platform. And thank you very much for allowing me to express my views.